In February 2023, the president assented to the Fisheries and Aquaculture Bill 2022. However, the bill has not been enforced 1 year later. During the meeting between the Minister of State for Fisheries, Helen Adoa, Minister of State for Industry, David Bahati, and members of parliament representing fishing communities, legislators expressed disappointment with the delayed operationalization of the law.
So, Honorable Minister, this law should be enforced. Pass the regulations so that the provisions that remove the presence of the UPDF should be taken, and we have the police trained to that effect, and they take over their post.
Very many stakeholders are out of this business. Tanzania charges 7,000 shillings per kilo of fish meal being exported. Kenya, fish meal is tax-free at export. How do you expect now the investors themselves, whom we want, they are also chatting the business. They are running away. What are we going to remain with?
Legislators registered their concerns that the UPDF brutality on the lakes is making it difficult to wait any longer for the new law to be enforced, since it abolished the Fisheries Protection Unit of the Army for the police-trained enforcement officers.
The petitioners gave in a list of names of the suspected illegal fishermen who have been killed in purported enforcement by UPDF. And one of them was from your district.
Some of our children in the country are in cells. And later on, when the officers ask for money and the others have to get out of cells because of illegal fishing, the way it is termed, as we await the regulations to know what is illegal fishing and which is not.
Moses Junior Okot-Bitek, the Member of Parliament for Kyuga County, broke down in tears as he narrated the ordeal of pain which fish dealers are going through at Lake Choga.
The victims are at my home. They came the other day to meet the Minister of Defense. They never went back. This lady is ever crying. I cannot even sleep in my home. She's in my living room as I speak now. I can't stay in my home. I've been sleeping in hotels. I said I have not met the minister. Somebody who has lost 50 million shillings and is at your place. You are completely beaten.
Lawmakers are also concerned that whereas the ministry is yet to enact regulations to enforce the new fisheries law, some victims are being tried in courts of law under the same law.
In court, Buganda Road Court, last week, about 22 people were charged under this law.
The new law.
Yes. In Buganda Road Court. And persons were, because they could not present sureties, which I could not transport from Amolata, I asked the persons to plead guilty. And I paid the fine of each person at 700,000 shillings for 22 people from my pocket.
Adoa conceded that the delayed enactment of the regulations is putting the fishing sector to a standstill.
Money should know the urgency of this matter, because now the regulations are holding everything. And we cannot move if the stakeholders are not consulted. So that is what I am suggesting. Allow me consult and I will come back to you.
The minister told MPs that inadequate funds have made it difficult for the ministry to carry out wide consultations to inform the making of the regulations needed to enforce the law.
There are some key places that you can't ignore, you must reach before you make the regulation. But the resource envelope is tying us and we cannot do much.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.